Hello everybody and welcome to yet more Perpetual Testing. For today's chamber we will be attempting to comprehend Ghost Train. This was created by the wonderful HugoBDesigner and recommended by the Oculus Dragon YT. So a very big thank you to HugoBDesigner and a very big thank you to the Oculus Dragon YT for this one. Okay, immediately as we enter the room we are greeted with a science button. A button that we shall stand on for scientific purposes. That button gives us a light bridge that goes over towards our exit directly in front of us. However, the light bridge doesn't actually appear to go half the way there. No, there's also a laser below it. I will point out at this point in the video, though, that HugoBDesigner maps that I've played in the past have been absolutely baffling to me. Not only in terms of, you know, working out the actual puzzle and solving the solution, but how in the hell HugoBDesigner actually comes up with the concept for the puzzle in the first place. It does say in the description that this one will take about 15 to 20 minutes, but that is Hugo time. So let's go ahead and convert that to ngeruma time. 35, 40? Yeah, this could be quite a long video. I do often find Hugo's maps to be very, very perplexing and baffling, and baffling appears to be a word that I am stuck on tonight, so I do apologize for that. We've got our light bridge that goes across some tracks down below with a laser, deadly, deadly goo encased each side in glass. We've got a great big glory hole in the wall there, although it's in glass, so that kind of defeats the purpose of a glory hole. You know what, let's not call it a glory hole, let's just say there's a big hole in the wall there. Let's not get too lowbrow too soon. We've got interesting music building up. Vaguely recognize that, but I don't know why. We can go down here with a set of very, very wonky steps by the looks of it. Some panels on the wall. We've got some deadly, deadly goo that goes all the way over towards our exit. There's a lone single panel out there. That's very interesting. And this just takes us up to glass to look at the rest of the deadly, deadly goo. Okay. Interesting. Tracks here that do suggest things go that way, mainly probably the laser and the light bridge. Past the big bit of glass, we've got a button in there that connects to something in that direction. Cube dropper connected to something in that direction. You know what, let's go back up the stairs and look at the things that are in that direction. Because, well, we can just go through that great big bit of fizzler there, can't we? And something tells me the great big bit of fizzler is going to be one of the major awkward points of solving this one. It does appear to be connected to this laser receptor here. Now, does that also mean that is a connection through there? HugoBDesigner tends to be very, very clear with their signage and ant lines and such. Notice I didn't say ant lines that time. I actually put a space in between the two words. That will apparently do our exit all the way over there. Okay, what else is through here? Through here then is another laser receptor, that one. That one will activate the cube dropper tube up there. And we've got another cube dropper tube here. This one is, however, very simply accessible by this button and panels that I don't quite trust. Crushing panels? Nah, Hugo doesn't do cheap shots like that, but I'm not going to trust it. Nah, see, Hugo does not do cheap shots like that. We've been delivered a cube with that weird sort of smushy purple colouring that it does for some reason. And that one is red, so cube management. Also, that one's a companion cube. Oh, lovely. Okay, there's a button down there with some sort of interesting architectural design choices. And a button down here on the floor. What's here? Here is an elevator. Are you automatic, perchance? You are automatic, perchance. Okay, cool. That's the easy way to get back up. You do. Oh, interesting. Okay. That looks very similar to that one, which connects to some... Ah, hold on. You line up with that, don't you? Which creates a whole portalable panel. Okay, cool. I don't think I've ever had to deal with constructing the panels to put portals on before. I like that concept, though. I'm sure it'll be a right pain in the ass at some point, but I like it. What else have we got down here? We've got you. Appears to be connected to this button. This button does something here on a timer. So where do we want to begin, I suppose? Well, we need cubes for creating whole panels, right? And we have a cube up there. We can't do anything else with this cube at the moment, as far as I can tell. Because, well, There's that giant great big bit of fizzler we were talking about. So let's grab you. Let's go stick you on the button down here, like so. Right, that constructs a whole portalable panel there and keeps it permanently open for us, which if we can get through, will let us get at that button there because, well, shortness makes it not possible from here. That's mesh there as well. Might be important that you can put a portal through there. Now we get to go use the giant glory hole, don't we? Don't stop calling it a glory hole. It's just a hole in the wall. Don't let your personal interests get in the way of science. Right, so that probably lines up nicely with you. Right, yeah, of course it does. There, we can get a clean shot over there. And then we can use these to let us get at that button. Yes, it does. Okay, we can perch directly on top of it because acrobatics are important, apparently. You do that on pretty long timer, actually. So that would make sense as a way to get back the other side. You're going to go off. Do I need a cube the other side? You're going to go off anyway, aren't you? Yeah, okay, so we know how to do that. That lets us get this cube past there, but then we lose that portalable panel, don't we? But we can probably do something again with it, and looks like that is also a construct your own portalable panel right there. So let's ride you up again. Through this way, the orange is still there, but then away it goes. Let's go over here again and get an angle to you. And you. Drop through here again, land on top of the button again. Let's put the blue on you. This is quite a long timer, so that might be a key point. Let's take you through to here, which does in fact give us a cube that we can stick upon this button here. That gives us a light bridge across to the middle of the room, but we no longer have the complete portal panel there. Over this side. Ah, I've just spotted something. You move, don't you? Yeah, because then you move, but you're currently blocking that light bridge. But if we get on you, light bridge goes all the way to the exit. So cube upon you, very, very important. Also, laser goes all the way to that one panel. Bit of panel there, bit of panel there. There's a view all the way through into here. Also, you go all the way through into the other side of the room as well, don't you? Okay, right, so it would probably make sense to keep you out the way for the moment. We could do that by simply going that way with a blue upon you. Let's go grab this cube. We're going to lose the light bridge though, right? But the laser stays on. The laser does stay on, and we clearly need lasers that side. Okay, let's take you over to moving that panel. Also, you know, cubes, different colors, possibly cube management. Although Hugo has told me in the past, sometimes it's just because it looks pretty. So let's put you on there. That will take you all the way over into that side of the room, where you line up with that piece there, creating a whole portalable panel. That probably wants laser-based science to come out of it, so let's put you on there. We can also go back with you. Take the wonky stairs up the top there. Anything going on with this? No, architectural decisions. Let's go back up the wonky stairs. And then we can use the hole in the wall to reposition those lasers. What have we got where? We got blue there. So if I put the orange on you now, what do you do? You get rid of this big bit of fizzler here. Well, I could go down here and I could get another cube. Is anything going to change in a bad way for me if I do that? Don't think so. Let's go stand upon you. You get bifurcated and turn that off, but we've still got the portal for the laser there. So if we do you, we do in fact get a cube. Has that done something else? No, that's me turning those lights on there. So a cube has dropped up there, which would suggest we need to go through there, right? To get that. Okay, we need to drop out of that one then, which means we need to find a panel the other side of the room. Kind of need to keep the portals though, right? Well, we can do that for the moment if we do you. Reactivates that. Also, just got to quickly check another Hugo idiosyncrasy of maps. No, lasers do not burn. They never do in a HugoBDesigner map. Again, just because it's better, really. Let's go grab you then. So we could grab you now if we Is there a place I'm blatantly going to need you immediately? I'd have to set things up again, but I think that might be half the point. So let's go ahead and put the orange. No, not the orange. Let's put the blue. Can't go through that way. Let's put the blue on you. I could just get the other one back, couldn't I? Whilst we're here, where is the other one at the moment? What's it doing? It's doing that panel there, which I think I want left out of the way for the moment. So let's get you manually with blue upon this one. Go through there. Oh, look. You can just make out the seam. Well, when you're coming through the other way of the source engine trying to comprehend that. Let's take you back up this way. Now I've kind of screwed myself, haven't I? Yes, because we're going to have to do the laser stuff again to get the fizzler out the way. Unless you keep things maintained here. You could maintain things here. Do I want you to maintain things here? What did that one do? We don't need to get you again, really, do we? So you could stay like that. And then use that one again? Do I want you kept over here? Well, no, we're going to have to move it anyway, aren't we? No, we're not, are we? Actually, no, we do need you, don't you? Because you... No, we don't need you, actually. Let's take you up here. Although I may be misthinking now. We do need the laser into this one, because that goes all the way around, right? To do the exit over the far end, I think. So that one needs to stay there. No angle through that way, so it's kind of a case of do everything again for the moment. Let's go into this part. Let's grab you from here. Do the orange upon you there. Bring you through to this side, which we can use to keep you activated. Which gives us the light bridge all the way across? It does. Huh. Okay. Am I missing something? Because I've never completed a HugoBDesigner map this quickly before. I feel like I've broken it? Or is this just a very simple HugoBDesigner introduction to recombobulating panels by placing them back together? It may well be. Very, very nice puzzle design, though. Yeah, I like that. I've never had to, like, recombine the panels to make the portalable surface before. That, as a concept-type design, is very, very nice, and that does actually appear to be the exit. So another quick video, I'm afraid, but I'm starting to get the feeling that some of you much prefer quick videos, because, well, I talk too much like I'm doing right now, so let's go ahead and go through the door. That was Ghost Train, created by the wonderfully talented and generally all-round nice person, HugoBDesigner. So a very, very big thank you to HugoBDesigner for that one. A very big thank you to the Oculus Dragon YT for recommending it. If you'd like to recommend a map for me to try and play, then please feel free to do so via the usual means. And until the next episode, or Perpetual Testing, on a more personal level, an extra special very big thank you to HugoBDesigner for the huge amount of help they've given me actually understanding how this game works, and who, alongside others, has been hugely important in making my Discord server actually a thing, because, well, it is actually a thing now, despite how often I forget it actually exists. So yeah, a very, very big thank you to HugoBDesigner for all their help, and of course a very big thank you for that wonderfully, logically satisfying kind of map to solve. So satisfyingly logical, in fact, that even old Spock would probably get a bit of a stirring in the downstairs of his Starfleet onesie. Thank you very much for watching. Catch you later.